So Apache Spark is another kind of framework for doing big data processing distributed across clusters, like MapReduce. The differences kind of come in how those computations are done. So for example, with Spark, you've got a lot more flexibility in the computations. So with MapReduce, you've got to do map and then reduce. Like, there's no way of getting around it. But in Spark, they provide like a load of different operations that you can do on the data, such as joins between different data structures.
Why would I use Spark?
Its purpose is to process large volumes of data. So it's maybe data that's not going to fit on a single node. But it's also computations that over a large volume of data, you don't want to go through and sequentially do that. And if you've got parts of your computation that are independent of each other, and so you can do it on the data items individually, you can split that data across the cluster and then do the computations on that single node, exactly like with MapReduce. It's the data locality principle again. Do the computations on the node where the data is stored, and then you reduce those results down to what you want. The main programming structure that you're going to be dealing with is called a resilient distributed dataset, which is usually shorter than 2RDD, which is kind of a collection of objects that are spread across a cluster. But as a programmer, when you're dealing with that, you're kind of just interacting with it as if it's on a single node, so it's kind of hidden from you, this is distributed. In a Spark cluster, you'll have a driver node and then several worker nodes. And the driver node is running the main program that kind of has all of the transformations that you want to do to your data. And then these kind of get sent out to the worker nodes, who then operate that on the chunks of data that they have. In Spark, the transformations can be similar to MapReduce, so it still provides the same map function and reduce functions. But then you have additional stuff on top of that, so they like give you a filter operation directly. So you don't have to implement that. You can just call a filter function on RDD and say, I only want to return objects for which this is true. So here we've just got a very, very simple Spark example of just loading in a text file from the local file system. And we're just going to go through and count the number of occurrences of each word. This is exactly the same as the MapReduce example we looked at last time, but we're doing this in Spark this time. Okay, so at the start, we set up a Spark config. So we just set the app name, which allows us to see easily which of our jobs is currently running within the web UI. We then set the Spark master. So because we're running this locally on a single computer, that's just local. We then set up a Spark context, which gives us access to like the Spark functions for dealing with RDDs. We first of all need to load our data into an RDD. So we do this using the text file function, and that puts the contents of that text file into an RDD. The RDD you can kind of just view as like an array if you want to. It's kind of like an array distributed across the cluster. So here we've got our lines RDD. Each element in the RDD is a single line from the text file. We then go through and split each line using the flat map function. So that maps a single function over every single item in the data set. So every line, we go through, split it up into words. And then because we're using flat map, that then takes that from an RDD of arrays to an RDD of strings again. We then go through, and exactly the same as in the MapReduce example, we use the map function to map each word to a key value pair, where the key is the word and then the value is the value one. So indicating we've got one instance of that word at that point. That then gives us a new RDD, and for that one, we go reduce by key. Instead of doing MapReduce, that would just be reduce. But here in Spark, if we just did reduce, it would give us a single value for the entire RDD back at the driver. Reduce by key takes an RDD of key value pairs. And for each key, you give it a function to apply to those values for how you want it to be combined. So for us, we want to add up the number of those instances of that word that we have. So we use just a simple plus to aggregate those values. So that finally gives us our word count RDD, which contains key value pairs of words and a number of instances of those words. And so we then call the collect function, which will bring that back to the driver node. And then for each one of those lines, we print them out. So we print out the counts for all those words.
So this, at the moment, that code is written for something that might be on your own computer. How would it differ if it was on a cluster, on a server farm or a massive data center or something like that? How would that vary?
So if you're running this on an actual cluster and not just on your local computer, then rather than setting master within your code and setting it to run locally, what you would do is you would have Spark running on the cluster, and you would use something called Spark Submit to submit your Spark jobs to Spark to then be run. So it's just a different way of running them, basically, rather than hard coding it within your program. Even though you're then running it on the cluster, the rest of the code would be the same. So the work that I've done with Spark has been kind of using it to analyze large volumes of telematics data coming off of lorries as they're driving around, and using the data from that to identify locations where incidents are occurring, such as if they're cornering harshly or braking harshly.
Outside of research, what sorts of things is Spark being used?
Yes, yeah, so Spark is used quite a lot in the real world. Like, you would find a lot of companies will be using it to kind of do large-scale jobs on all of the data that they have. And it can be used for like analysis or simply just processing that data and putting it into storage. The good thing about the distributed computing in clusters is that if you want to scale the program more, you just add more like nodes to the cluster. So the point is, if you want to increase your processing power, you don't have to buy new hardware in terms of replacing your old hardware. You keep your old hardware, you buy new nodes and just stick them on the end, and you've instantly increased how much processing power you have. So if you suddenly, say, get a load more data that you need to be processing, you think, oh, this current cluster size, that's not great. We can then expand that and then just add a few more nodes. So the Spark program would then just scale automatically. Going back to RDDs, these are immutable data structures. So,
and that immutable means they can't be changed, right? Is that right?
Yes, yeah. So yeah, they're immutable, they cannot be changed. Once they're created, you can pass them on to other functions, but you can't change the contents of that single RDD. So what a Spark program ends up being is kind of a chain of transformations, with each one creating a new RDD and passing it on to the next function. The advantage of the RDDs is that they can be persisted in memory, which means that then it's more efficient to reuse them later in the computation. So one of the disadvantages of Hadoop MapReduce is that every time you're writing stuff to disk, basically, after your MapReduce computation, if you want to reuse it, you've then got to go and get it from disk again. Whereas with Spark, you can just persist the RDDs in memory. If you want to come back to them later, then you can do really easily.
You're saying large amount volumes of data. Can we put some numbers on this? What are we looking at here?
So yeah, the volumes of data we're talking about can vary, I guess, depending on company. It's probably ranging gigabytes to terabytes, and then the biggest would then just keep going up, right. Basically.